Hi, in this video, we are going to talk about data normalization and how to scale our data in Python programming language, and also why do we need to scale our data. So first of all, let's print the X train, and if I run the code, you can see we have two columns, which we have talked in the previous videos. This is the age column, and this is the salary column. But as you can see, the scale of these two columns are drastically different. But maybe you ask, so what? What's the problem? The problem is this, because the scale of these two columns are drastically different, maybe some models, not all models, some models are going to be deceived by these different feature scales. Why? Because maybe they think that this column, which the scale is drastically bigger than this column, is much more important. So in order to help the model, in order to not be deceived by the scale of these two columns, we should scale our columns. I mean, we should bring our features to similar scales. In this video, we want to talk about two well-known methods for scaling our data. The first one is MinMax Scaler, and the second one is Standard Scaler. So now let's talk about MinMax Scaler. This is the formula of MinMax Scaler. First, we need to subtract our data, by the minimum of that column, and then we should divide that by the maximum minus minimum of that column. And this gives us a result, which is the transformed of our X, of our initial X, I mean. So now we have scaled our X. So in order to do min-max scaler in Python programming language, we should simply type from sklearn.preprocessing, import min-max scaler. Then we need to create an object of this min-max scaler. And for example, suppose that we want to name that object scaler. And then we simply type scalar.fitTransform, because we want to fit and also transform our xTrain. And then we are going to update our xTrain. I mean, we are going to store the result in a variable again called xTrain. It means that we are going to update our xTrain. And then we simply type scalar.transform and not fit, because we are not going to fit on our x test. We are just going to transform our scalar on our x test. And then we are going to update our x test. And remember that you should just fit your scalar on xTrain, not x test. You should just transform on x test. And now if I print xTrain, and if I run the code again, you can see the scale of these two columns are now similar. But let's talk about another famous scaler, which we call it standard scaler, which the transformed value, I mean x prime, is equal to x, I mean each value, subtracted by the mean of that column, divided by the standard deviation of that column. And this gives us a result, which is the transformed of our x. So in order to scale our data with a standard scaler in Python programming language, first we should import the proper packages. So we simply type from sklearn.preprocessing, import standard scaler, and then we should create an object of a standard scaler. And for example, suppose that we want to name that object scalar, and then we similarly type scalar.fitTransform on xTrain, and we are going to update our xTrain. And also we are going to simply type xTrain.transform on our xTest, and then we are going to update our xTest. And now if I print xTrain again, and if I run the code, you can see again the scale of these two columns are similar. But maybe you ask, which one is better? Is min-max scaler better or standard scaler is better? The general answer is it depends on your data, but usually a standard scaler is performing better than the min-max scaler. In the next tutorial, we are going to talk about k-nearest neighbors algorithm in Python programming language.